All right. Hello friends, welcome to Yaar's YouTube channel. My name is Ayush Rathi and this is another episode of Tricks and Cheat Codes. In this episode, I have taken KCET questions again. Let me remind you all, I make content in Hindi language, but because many of the Karnataka students don't know Hindi, so I am making Karnataka CET Tricks and Cheat Codes series only in the English language. I make Tricks and Cheat Codes of many other exams as well, Maharashtra CET, JEE Main, NEET, etc., etc. So there is a complete playlist for the Tricks and Cheat Codes, and in that playlist, the videos which are containing KCET questions, I have made a separate playlist of that, and you can find the link in the description. All the KCET videos are updated in that particular playlist. So for 2021 aspirants, if you are looking for KCET tricks and cheat codes, you can go through only that playlist. I have covered trigonometry, I have covered straight lines. In this video, I am covering integration. A lot of students have commented in my previous videos that suggested to make videos on integration, tricks and cheat codes for integration. So in this video, you'll get amazing tricks for integration questions, and you will be able to solve a lot of previous year questions using those tricks which will be provided in this video. It is a unique channel where you get this unique content of tricks and cheat codes. Trust these tricks and cheat codes. These are not just ordinary tricks, and this will not harm you in any way. This will obviously help you to boost your score, and it is tested, proven by me and a lot of students in different examinations of India, including the JEE Main and NEET examination. Okay, so let's get started with this video. Come on. Okay, so here I have taken KCET previous year questions from the integration chapter. A lot of students were commenting in my previous videos that sir, make tricks and cheat codes for the KCET integration portion. Many questions come from the integration part. So I have taken integration questions, recent questions 2019-2020, and here on the back side you can see 2020. So I have observed the KCET previous year questions from the integration part, and I realized that many questions can be done by just using my tricks. Okay, so the thing is, I have taken 2019 question. I'll show you the trick for this question. If you understand this, you will easily be able to apply trick in this question because both the questions are similar, right? So it is very easy to crack KCET examination with a very good rank. If you follow these tricks, you can improve your score, and if you follow the previous year questions, you can get an idea of what type of questions are coming repeatedly. Okay, so in this question, many students don't know how to integrate. To be very honest, this question, many students won't know the integration. So if any student knows the integration, you can do it. I am not saying suggesting not to do, but if you are about to leave this question, then don't leave this question. Instead, apply my trick. It will be very easier to solve this question. So what you can do is, instead of integrating, you can differentiate. You can do the reverse process. So what you can do is differentiate this, you will get this. So a log x minus 1 differentiation will be a upon x minus 1. Right, then it will be plus b upon x plus 2, right, and then it will be c upon x minus 3, because log x derivative is 1 by x. So it becomes like this, and constant derivation is 0. Now clearly this is not equal to this, but if we put these values, then it will become equal. So first of all, what we will do is we'll put x equals to 0. If I put x equals to 0, here I'll get a upon minus 1, right? I'll get a upon, or I'll say this is minus a, right? If I put x equals to 0, I'll get this as b upon 2. If I put x equals to 0, I'll get minus c upon 3. Are you getting it? And I'll put x equal to 0 here as well. If I put x equals to 0 here as well, then I'll get minus 1, right? If I put x equals to 0, I'll get minus 1. And here I'll get, if I put x equals to 0, I'll get minus 3, minus 1, 3, 3 to the 6. So I'll get minus 1 by 6. Are you getting it? So I'm getting minus 1 by 6. So this both has to be equal, right? Instead of integrating, I have differentiated and put x equals to 0. So this should be minus 1 by 6. So now I need to check the options. I'll put the options and check which option will lead me to minus 1 by 6. So starting from the first option, if I put minus a, so this will become 1 by 6. Then I'll put b by 2, that means 1 by 6 again, and then it will be minus c by 3, that means plus 1 by 6. So this is coming as, this is not equal to minus 1 by 6, right? So very clearly I can eliminate this option. Next option I'll check 1 by 6, so this will be, I'm checking b option, this was a option. Then 1 by 6 I'll put minus 1 by 6, and then I'll put minus 1 by 6 again, and then it will be minus 1 by 9. So also you can see this is not equal to this, right? Are you getting it? Because if you take the LCM and all, this will not be equal. So you can eliminate this option. Got it? Okay. Now see the third option. If you put 1 by 6 here, I'll get minus 1 by 6, then 1 by 3 here, I'll get plus 1 by 6. So both these get cancelled, and then 1 by 5, so it will become minus 1 by 15. So again, this is not equal to minus 1 by 6. I can eliminate this option. D option will be the correct one. You can check, put D option here. If I put D option, minus 1 by 6, it will become 1 by 6, and then minus 1 by 3 will become minus 1 by 6, right? It will get cancelled, and then 1 by 2 I'll put here, so it will become minus 1 by 6. These two will get cancelled. This is equal to minus 1 by 6. So D is satisfying. So very quickly, you see, in 2-3 minutes I got the answer. So if you even integrate, you will take 1.5 minute or 2 minutes, right? So a little extra time, because our luck was bad, the answer came in D. If suppose the answer came in A or B, it would have been even more faster than this, right? So instead of leaving the question, you can do this alternate methods in integration questions, in the indefinite integration questions, to get the answer. Now you can pause this video and try this and comment the answer below, and then you can see the solution, because it will also help you develop the habit. So you do the same thing in this question. This question came recently, 2020, last year. So you can pause the video and comment the answer, and then you start continuing the video. Okay, so now I think you have solved this and commented the answer. Now I'll show you the solution using the same trick, right? You can also integrate this, but if students don't know integration, you can follow this trick. So what I can do is I'll differentiate this. If I differentiate this, I'll get A upon x minus 1, then I'll get B upon x minus 2, and then I'll get C upon x minus 3, and plus C differentiation will be 0. Okay, so now what I'll do it, I'll put 0 here. So if I put 0 here, I'll get minus A, right? I'll get minus B by 2, and I'll get minus C by 3. So I need to compare this with this, right? So first of all, I need to put 0 here as well. So if I put 0 here, this will get cancelled. If I put 0 here, all this will become 0. So this will become minus 3, minus 2, minus 1. In product, it will be minus 6. So 1 by 6 minus, so minus 1 by 6. Again, similar to this, this is also coming as minus 1 by 6. So can you understand the pattern? These KCET papers, many questions come from the previous year itself. Just few values are changed. You can see minus 1 by 6 here, minus 1 by 6 here as well. Okay, and you can also see x minus 1, x plus 2. Similarly here, x minus 1, x minus 2, just a plus sign has been changed to minus sign. And rest the question almost remains the same. Okay. So now what I'll do is I'll put these options here, and I'll check which option is giving me minus 1 by 6. So I'll start one by one. If I check option A, I'll put 2 here, this will become minus 2, and then I'll put minus 7 here, this will become plus 7 by 2, and then I'll put minus 5 here, this will become 5 by 3. Are you getting it? So I need to take the LCM. So if I take the LCM, it is 6, this will be minus 12, plus this will be 21, plus this will be 10. So very clearly, this is not equal to this minus 1 by 6. Are you getting it? This is 21 plus 10, 31 minus 12. This is not equal to minus 1 by 6. So I can eliminate this option. Next, I'll put option B and check. So I'll put option B, I'll get minus 5. Then I'll get plus 7 by 2. And then I'll get minus 5 by 3. Again, I'll take the LCM. LCM is 6. So this will be minus 30 plus 21 minus 10. So again, this is not equal to minus 1 by 6. So I can eliminate this option very clearly. So this option can also be eliminated. Again, if I do it with the C option, I put the C option, it will be minus 2 and then minus 7 into minus by 2. So it will be plus 7 by 2 and then 5, it will be minus 5 by 3. So if I take the LCM, it will be 6, it will be minus 12 plus 21 minus 10. So this is minus 12 and minus 10. So minus 22, minus 22 plus 21, minus 1, minus 1 by 6. So this is the correct answer. Instead of doing the integration, we are getting the answer. You can also check option D. If I check option D, I'll put minus 5 and then plus 7 by 2 and then 5 by 3. If you check this, this will not be correct, because it is similar to this one. Only the difference is here it was minus 2, here it is minus 5, right? Rest remains the same. 7 by 2 minus 5 by 3. Oh no, here it is plus 5 by 3. So okay, let me take the LCM once. So 6, so this will be minus 30 plus 21 plus 10. So this is coming as 21 plus 10. 31. Okay, this is coming as plus 1 by 6, not minus 1 by 6. Are you getting it? If you solve this, it is coming as plus 1 by 6, because 21 and 10 is 31 minus 31, 1 by 6. But we needed minus 1 by 6. So this option also gets eliminated. Are you getting it? By this way, you can solve the questions. Okay, let me know if there is any calculation mistake, because it has become very clumsy. So even I am a human being, I can make calculation mistakes. So if at all there is any calculation mistake, let me know. If there is no calculation mistake done by my side, then also let me know that, sir, there was no calculation mistake from your side. Okay, now the last question, this is very important question. If you understand the trick of this question, you will love it. You will be able to solve many questions using tricks in the integration part. So many students can't do the integration, but of course many students know the differentiation. So what I'm suggesting you is differentiate the options. First differentiate the options and then see the magic. So if I differentiate each of the options, just differentiate each of the options, keep two aside. So I am keeping two in the bracket. Okay, then keep it. You know the method of differentiation, right? UV method, keep U differentiate V and plus keep V differentiate U. So I'll keep e to the power sin x, and I'll differentiate this, it will give me cos x, right? And then I'll keep sin x plus 1 as it is, and I'll differentiate this e to the power sin x, and using the chain rule, sin x derivative will be cos x. So this is the complete differentiation. Are you getting it? Similarly, I'll do for all the options. 2, I'll keep 2 outside, then e to the power sin x, I'll keep as it is, cos x plus 1 derivative is minus sin x, getting it? Plus I'll keep cos x plus 1 as it is, and then I'll differentiate e to the power sin x, that will again give me e to the power sin x using the chain rule dot cos x in the product, getting it? Then I'll differentiate the third option, keeping 2 aside, e to the power sin x, right? Cos x minus 1 derivative will be minus sin x again, plus I'll keep cos x minus 1 on one side, and then I'll differentiate e to the power sin x, and using the chain rule cos x will also come. In the last option, I'll differentiate 2, I'll keep aside, e to the power sin x, then sin x minus 1 derivative is cos x, plus I'll keep sin x minus 1 as it is, and then again the same thing will come like this. Now, very clearly, this is not equal to this, but we can compare, na? We can at least compare. What we can do? We can take x equals to 0. See, what we do? Take x equals to 0. If I take x equals to 0, what happens to the original one? If I take x equals to 0, this will become sin 0, everything will become 0, so this is coming as 0. Now check what options come 0. You put x equal to 0 here as well. So if I put x equals to 0 here, you check very clearly, option A you check. If I put x equals to 0, cos 0 will become 1, this will become 1, right? E to the power 0 will become 1, so this will become 2 into 1, and here it will become sin 0 0 plus 1 cos 0 1. So again it will all become 1. So this is not coming equal to 0, right? This is not equal to 0. So we can eliminate the first option. This is not coming as 0, right? So we can eliminate the first option. Are you getting it? Similarly, check option B. You put 0, sin 0 0, we are getting here 0. This is 0. And then again, this is cos 0 1. So again this is not coming as 0. So again plus something, this will be something, not 0. This is not 0, right? Because cos 0 is 1, e to the power sin 0, e to the power 0 is 1, and here also cos 0 is 1. This will be 2, something like that. So this is also not equal to 0. So we can eliminate the B option as well. Are you understanding? Now next, what we can do is we can check the C option. If we check the C option, we'll get sin 0 is 0, right? Also here cos 0 is 1, but 1 minus 1 will be 0, so this will give me 0. So this option can be an answer. This option can be an answer. Also check option D. If I check option D, then it will be cos 0 is 1, this will give me 1, 2 into this will give me 1, and this will give me this will give me minus 1. So 1 minus 1, again this is coming as 0. So both C and D answer can happen. Now because this is a single correct answer, we have to eliminate between C and D as well. So let's take another value. Let me take any other value. I can take x as 90 degree. If I take x equals to 90 degree, if I take x equals to 90 degree, then sin 90 will be 1, e to the power 1 will be 1, so this will give me e, right? And sin 90, 9 into 180, sin 180 is 0, so this will be e into 0, so ultimately it will again give me 0, right? So now I will check these two options only by putting x equals to 90 degrees. If I put x equals to 90 degree in the C option, I'll get sin 90 is 1, so this will be minus 1, so this will be 2, and this will be 1 minus e, this will be minus e actually, and here sin 90, cos 90 is 0, so this will be minus e, minus so this will give me 0 because cos 90 is 0, this will be 0 plus 0. So again this is not giving me 0, right? This is giving me something 2 into minus 1, something like that. So I'll check option D as well at last. So if I put 90 degree here, cos 90 is 0, this is clearly giving me 0 at 90 degree also, and this is also giving me 0 because cos 90 term is here also. So if I put 90 degree, this term entirely is 0, this term entirely is 0, so this will be 2, 0 plus 0, which is equals to 0. So finally my answer will be D, and C option also gets eliminated. So I'll go with D option, because if I put C option 90 degree, it is not coming as 0, but we wanted 0 even after putting x equals to 90 degree, because the integration is coming to be 0. So what we did is, instead of integrating, we differentiated the options and we compared it with the integration, because integration and differentiation are the reverse process of each other. So by using these tricks in integration, you can solve a lot of questions. Now go to the previous questions and start solving using my tricks. You'll be able to get a lot of questions, right? Thank you so much for watching. So I hope you really love these tricks. Even I like making these tricks for you. And you can also comment in the comment section, and you can suggest some more chapters for which you want tricks. I'll try to make those tricks as quickly as possible, because KCET exams are very near. So I want you all to get really charged up for the examination, and I want to help you all as much as possible. So if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share it with all your friends who are going to write KCET 2021 examination. Thank you so much for watching.